Hey, it's Allison from Computers.mom, and this video will show you how to clean out storage space on your Mac quickly, easily, and safely. The storage space, also called disk space on modern computers, is quite expensive, and over time, as you accumulate more and more stuff, you may find you're running out of room. That can make your Mac run really slowly, prevent you from installing updates, or trigger a bunch of error messages like these. If you're running low on storage space, you have two basic options. Either get rid of stuff you don't need, or move stuff you're not currently using off the computer. But how? There are plenty of fancy apps you can buy for this purpose, but you probably don't need them because built into every Mac is a pretty great tool for cleaning out the storage space on your computer. That's the subject of this video. So let's take a look. To get started, click the Apple menu on the upper left-hand corner of your screen and select About This Mac. I'm zooming in here so it's easier to see. This window opens with all the essential details about your computer. Note that this MacBook Air has the latest version of the operating system, macOS Monterey. But don't worry, if you're running an older operating system like Big Sur or Catalina, things may look a little different, but you'll still have what you need. At the top of this window, click on Storage. You can see that there are two storage drives listed here, but the lessee one is a backup drive that's plugged into the Mac. It's an external hard drive. Most Macs only have one internal hard drive where all your stuff is stored, apps, documents, and so forth. That's the one we need to work on. Here's the total size of the drive, both numerically in gigabytes and visually as a bar. We can see how much is in use, and it looks like we have all this white space available. But we can't use all that space. We have to keep at least 10% of it free, or the computer will slow to a crawl. If you think of your hard drive as a closet where you keep all your stuff, the closet can't be completely full or you won't be able to get in. So if we can only use about 90% of the total space, then this is all the space that's actually available, and it's even more important to keep things cleaned out. See how it says calculating? Wait for that to finish, and after a few moments, you'll see a visual representation of what is taking up the space on this drive. Moving your mouse pointer over each colored section reveals the details. Wow, trash is taking up a lot of space. To access the built-in tools for cleaning out the disk, click the Manage button. It can take a few moments for the details to fill in, but eventually down the left, you'll see how much space different types of content is taking up on your computer. We want to focus on the things that take up the most space, that is, things measured in gigabytes. If you're not clear on the difference between gigabytes and megabytes and so on, check out the video linked above. Everything below this line is stuff we can't clean up from this window, like the operating system that runs the computer and files that belong to other users of this computer. But in the top section, we can see that while documents are taking up the biggest chunk of space, trash, as we saw before, is taking up quite a lot too. Recommendations is already selected, so that's what we're seeing in the main part of the window over here, where Apple gives us four options to reclaim space on the hard drive. But before you just start blindly following these recommendations, it's a good idea to understand some of their pros and cons. That's especially true of this first option, which looks so easy. If you choose Store in iCloud, the full-size copies of your files, the stuff on your desktop, in your Documents folder, in your Photos library, whatever you choose, will be copied to your iCloud account. If you run low on disk space, the full-sized versions are removed from your computer and replaced with a smaller version. Apple keeps everything in sync, and if you ever need the full-sized version on your computer, it will automatically download. Using iCloud this way has a lot of advantages. It can free up a lot of space on your computer, but the trade-off is that it can take up a lot of space in iCloud instead. You only get 5 gigabytes of iCloud storage space for free with your Apple ID. And the minute that gets filled up, you have to start paying Apple every month for extra space, forever. It's not very expensive per month, but over time that can add up. And if you change your mind, it's not always easy to get back to where you started. So don't rush into this option. Think carefully about whether it makes sense for you. The second option, Optimize Storage, removes from your computer video content that you've already watched. Video files tend to be really large, so that seems like a good idea, but it only applies to movies and TV shows in the Apple TV app, so it's a bit limited in helpfulness. The third option is much more likely to be useful. When you delete stuff on a Mac, it goes into trash, but it's not really gone. It stays there, which is great if you delete something by mistake because you can get it back, but it's still taking up space on your hard drive until you empty the trash, which many people never get around to doing. That's why the trash is so large here. It's never been emptied. If we turn on empty trash automatically, your Mac will permanently delete anything that has been in the trash for at least 30 days. That's usually enough time to notice if you deleted something by accident, so it's fairly safe. And not only will this free up space now, it will continue to do so in the future. So if you're low on space, this option can be really helpful. Finally, let's look at reduce clutter. Notice that when I choose this option on the right in recommendations, documents is now highlighted on the left. In the main part of the window, we see our documents, but they're organized in a very specific way. I'm going to blow this up so you can see it better. Notice that we are looking at large files and they're sorted by size. You can tell that because size is bold and there's a little caret symbol next to it. So we're looking at our files sorted by size from largest to smallest, regardless of where they are stored on the Mac. That makes it easy to find and delete the biggest files if you don't need them anymore. For example, see how these first two very large files have the same name, but they have different dates and sizes. They're not the same. And if we click on each one, we can see that the first one is in the Downloads folder, and the second one is in the Movies folder. That second one is a keeper, but I don't need the one in Downloads, so I can select it, click Delete, and then Confirm. Boom! When we're finished reviewing the large files, we can also click here to look at the contents of our Downloads folder. Like trash, Downloads is another location that tends to accumulate a lot of junk and never get cleaned out. In this section, the list is organized a little bit differently. Files are grouped by when they were last used and then sorted by size within each group. The first group, as you can see, is older than a year. And then the next group is older than 6 months but less than a year, and so on. Look over the oldest files and make sure that there's nothing you need to keep. I'm going to select all these files that are older than a year. If you haven't learned, by the way, how to select a whole bunch of items at once like that on a Mac, check out the video linked above. Life's too short to delete things one at a time, so being able to select multiple items at once like this is super useful. The other options here are normally less useful, so we're going to skip over them. Applications can also take up a fair amount of space, and it's worth checking for apps you don't use to see if you can delete them. Remember that if you delete an app that comes from the App Store, you can always re-download it if needed. The biggest apps in here are ones that I use all the time. I only see a few things I don't need anymore, and they're not very big, so I'm going to leave those alone. It's not worth the time. Finally, if you use the Messages app on your Mac, you may not realize that you may still be storing every baby picture and cat video and stupid little GIF that anyone ever sent you. Individually, they're not that big, but there are a lot of them. You can sort by size or by how long ago you looked at them and delete as needed. I'm going to dump all the stuff from 2019. Pretty sure I don't need those. So if you are short of space on your Mac, these tools won't clean out every nook and cranny, but they can go a long way toward reclaiming useful space without a whole lot of effort. As always, thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments and questions below. Click like if you found this helpful, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.